Hello. In 2022, Sonlight is updating and rolling out several new products. So right now, we are going to talk a little bit about our new Science D program. I am Sunny, Sonlight's community manager and a Sonlight mom of two, and I am being joined by Amber. Amber, can you tell us a little bit more about you and what you do at Sonlight?
Sure. My name's Amber, and I work in product development. I've been in product development almost 20 years now. I've written all kinds of programs from language arts to science. I worked on our Mathtacular videos. I'm in the science videos sometimes. So currently, my current project is to work through the experiments in our new program, develop those. I helped Sarita pick books for the new science programs also. So science has been my life the last 3 years or so, and it's been so much fun.
Perfect. Yeah, so you're definitely the expert then on all things science. And I know you're famous from the Mathtacular DVDs and science DVDs. My kids were super excited I was going to get to talk to you because they know you from those products.
Oh, yay! How fun!
So thank you so much for being here. And I'm actually going to be using Science D in the upcoming school year with my son. So I'm really excited to talk with you and hear about these latest updates. And for those who are unfamiliar, Sonlight has been updating our elementary science packages for the last couple of years. So can you give us kind of a general overview or describe what science with Sonlight is like?
Yes. So first and foremost, we love our literature at Sonlight, right? So we start by picking out the best science books we can find. This year, we're looking at what the topics in NGSS cover at each different grade level, just so that we can be on pace with the educational culture this in today and really update and be fresh and current. So we picked books that align with those topics. Now, it doesn't mean we're completely tied to what we're doing, because we do pull in things we value as Sonlighters. But we still use these great books. They're super colorful. They're totally engaging. I taught my son last year with Sonlight, and science was his favorite subject because he would just read these books and devour them. We have a science dictionary this time in D. We have Encyclopedia of Planet Earth. We have a new book on coding, which is super fun. If you buy the 5-day, you'll learn about energy. Not just electricity and power, but also forces are in here too. And waves. Waves, part of energy, is how energy travels. So there's fun learning about frequency and wavelength. And then Mysteries and Marvels of Nature does our biology portion of this this level. And then the 5-day is a super, super fun focus on engineering. My older brother's an engineer, so I think this is super fun and a great way to introduce kids. What is it like? How do we make stuff? Who comes up with the stuff we make? Guess what? You could be an engineer one day too, and be in charge of making the stuff that we all need. So there's a DK, really cool DK book on just engineering extreme machines and power and all kinds of things. And then this engineering design at work talks about all the different fields of engineering. From civil engineering to electrical to mechanical. So it kind of gives you an introduction to, if I do want to be an engineer, what kind of engineer do I want to be? So, and then our biography, this level, is Hedy Lamarr. She's kind of an amazing person. Not only was she an actress, but she helped develop, radar for World War II. So very smart woman. Love it. And she's a girl, right?
Yeah.
All those science girls.
Love it. So when it comes to creating science programs, you were talking about like the engineering and coding and the different topics that are going to be included in D, but how do you identify kind of what the focus of that level will be and then what books to use for that level?
So we do look at the NGSS standards, and we kind of take all the standards that are designated for fourth grade. And there's lots of different ways you can cover standards if you want to. We decided to just use, okay, NGSS has said this is a fourth grade standard. So we align to that so that we can pick our literature that we love. Our literature is kind of the heartbeat of everything we do. And so these are really important. And we work really hard to make sure everything, our activity sheets talk about this. And then new this year, the experiments you read. So let's talk about your week a little bit. Okay. You'll read for 3 days if you are doing 4-day, And then on your last day, you do an experiment. And if you're doing 5 day, you'll read for 4 days and have an experiment. Well, you read 3 days, have an experiment. And then the fifth day is one of those super fun engineering books. So after you've read for 3 days, you do an experiment that relates to everything you just read about. So in the biology section, when you're reading the biology book, you'll do things with plants and cells and that sort of thing. When you're doing waves, you'll do light and and I think there's maybe, I'm mixing my grade levels up. Third grade, we have a microwave experiment, has to do with waves. But yes, so your fourth day makes a lot of sense because it ties into what you just read about the rest of the week. So it's kind of taking it out of the book and bringing it into the real world. And your kids are just gonna have so much fun with those experiments.
Yeah, I love that the experiments tie in now, with everything that they're learning all week, and it makes sense. It makes it applicable to real life. Yes. So do you have to do Science B with HBLD, or can you use it regardless of the level that you're doing in other subjects? Or can you maybe combine the kids for science?
Oh my goodness. Let's combine those kids. Save you mommies. Let's combine kids. You do not have to do it with HBL. Yes, and you can do it with multiple kids. If you do, you might want to buy, the experiment book, which I'll talk about in a minute, comes with a paper packet that they're kind of consumables, like our activity sheets that you might use up. So you might want to buy an extra paper packet or two if you want your kids to be able to do their own whatever it is. It depends on the experiment. Sometimes it's fine if they work together to build the thing in the experiment and they all see together what happens. So it's just kind of up to you. And if you do want multiple paper packets, you might want to buy two kits also, but you could always also start with one and then decide that later if you wanted to get two. But yeah, so you don't have to tie it to your HBL. You can do this if the topics look super interesting to you or to your kids. Just go for D if you like.
I love it. Yeah, you talked a little bit about the experiments, how they're once a week and tie in to everything else. Can you talk a little bit about the experiment portion of science? You know, what are the perks of that Discover a New Kit? You know, how did we make it easy for parents to do the experiments? Let's talk a little bit about that.
Let's do. So our experiment book is brand new, and we wrote it in a way where you as a parent can just come to the start of the experiment. You might want to look at it the day before, because sometimes there's you need to get this ready for the experiment tomorrow. We try to put a note in the IG if that's true too, but the experiments themselves are super beautiful and colorful. There's a list right at the top of equipment you need. Anything that's not in the kit should be easily found around your house. We usually put a list in the IG too, if it's something you might want to buy the week before just to have on hand. But then you can pick the book up and just start reading. And you're going to start teaching your kids as soon as you're reading, and you don't have to know anything. You can just read and learn right along with them. And then as you go and it's time to start building something, we have great steps to show you what to do with all of those things you collected. So you just follow through the steps. And as you discover something amazing, we teach you in here what you just saw. So just keep reading. It's very easy. And then there's sometimes fun little comments on the sidebars and things like that. And at the end of the experiment, we have some questions to help your kids kind of wrap up what we just did, pull out the important pieces. And then there's a fun takeaway, like, okay, this is the point of what we just did. And you just read it, it's fine. And at the very end, there's also some go further activities. So if you had so much fun doing that, there's some things you could send your kids off to go do on their own, or do a little internet research with them on something that relates to the experiment you just did. So the learning doesn't have to stop just because the experiment did. So there's lots of fun to be had every week with our experiments.
Yeah, I love that. Like you said, just start reading and then you can teach it. That's probably my favorite thing about all of Sonlight, is that you don't have to come into it with a lot of background knowledge. You can just start teaching and learn along with your kids. So how do you guys determine, you know, what the experiments are going to be? And then what is the testing process like to make sure that they're going to work when people start to do them?
Yes. Okay. So we did choose NGSS because I like several things about it. I like that it not only says, hey, this year you need to learn space, this year you're going to do waves. It also talks about scientific practices and engineering practices, things good scientists do that help them learn better. Things like observing patterns, recording data to other people. And so we look at the standards to rope all of these things in to help your kids become really good scientists. So they're practicing these skills and things as they're doing the experiments. So we look at that. So we look at the standards, we look at what topic are we talking about this week? And then we come up with an activity that kind of marries those two things together. So that's what you're getting in the experiment book. Refresh me what your other question was.
Oh yeah, and then how do you test them? Like, what is that process like once you get the idea for the experiment? How do you mm-hmm. make sure it works and write it and do all of that to have right. that in that book?
So we have an idea. We kind of write out how we think it might work. Often my son helps me test things at home because he loves this stuff. But we do have a team of testers in the office that takes the final experiment and works all the way through it. They get the actual supplies that we would send in the kit. Does this work? Does this not work? And then they give us feedback and I go back through and I say, okay, let's tweak this. And so it's a little bit refined by the time you guys get it. So it should work. Well, it should be reliable by the time you get it. And we do try to look, one thing we do too is we build it and then somebody goes, but I think it would be easier if you built it this way. So we try to also refine your steps so that what you're working through is pretty seamless and makes sense and you're not doing something that doesn't make sense and then you have to backtrack. So it should be pretty fun to do by the time you get it seamless and you're not gonna have a big faux pas while you're trying to teach and the experiment didn't work, which can happen anyway, but we're trying to avoid that because we do test to yeah. make it good for you.
Well, that's great. Like you said, the books are very colorful. They're engaging, you know, and provide all the instructions to make it very easy for families to do that. So, you know, level D is kind of a level where kids are becoming slightly more independent. So when it comes to science, how much parental involvement is required for science D, do you think? Would the parents just need to help with the mm-hmm. experiments? Do they need to do the whole program like they would in younger levels? What do you think?
So I would say it kind of depends on your child. My son was super engaged in science, and so I could have him do his reading on his own, and then he would work through the activity sheet questions on his own. If you're doing it with multiple kids, you might want to do the reading as a group and then talk through those questions as a group so that your younger kids don't have to do all the writing. There's not a ton of writing, but sometimes that shuts kids down. So I would say just make them discussion questions and keep it light and fun. For the experiments, I would say still at this level, work through them with your kids, just because sometimes there's notes to parents about, hey, this might happen later. Like, just be advised, don't give away the goods yet. Let them puzzle through this. So it's tipping you off to some things. But also it's just so much fun. Do it with them because it's fun and it's easy and they're going to have a great time and they'll just be making memories with your science program, I think so.
Yeah, absolutely. What do you think the best part of Science D is? You talked about the great literature and the experiments, but what's your favorite part?
Well, I love the books because they're beautiful and they're fresh and they're new. And plus we have, I mean, this one has been around in our curriculum, but it's still great information and it really ties into the topics used in this level. I love the experiments too. Just that time of doing and the fact that they relate to what we've read about this week. So it's not this offshoot anymore. It's now, okay, let's take what you've read and bring it into the real world and let's experience it and then think about it in different ways. And then how else could this apply to my life? So it's just, yeah. And there's a couple of fun ones in here. They'll make a volcano, which is classic, right?
Yeah.
But not just that, they'll make it erupt a couple of times in different ways. And they'll see, because some volcanoes do erupt several times over time. And as the lava hardens, it makes layers of rock. And then at the end of the experiment, they're going to do a core sample of the rock and test to see which of the layers included iron. So that's pretty interesting. Trying to think if there's another, you get to make an electromagnet in this level too, which is super fun.
Yeah, so that does sound fun. And I love how it takes it one step further than maybe the volcano experiment you've done before. You're learning new things.
Yes.
but still in a fun way. So I love that. Well, Amber, thank you so much for being here to tell us all about the new and improved Science D. Like I said, I'm going to use it this upcoming school year, so I'm really excited about that. And for anyone watching, the new science program is going to be available on the Sonlight website starting March 31st. So make sure you check that out.
Thanks, Sunny.